calculate forward rate 1 year from now. If the spot rate for 1 year is 8% and spot rate for 2 year is 10%. Now, there are three possible methods through which these kind of questions can be solved on the exam. The first method is the logic method. Second one is the formula. And third one, commonly referred to as the magic method. Okay, now, on the exam, if the options are not close to each other, simply the approximation of the magic method will work for you. So how do we deal with this? We know that for 2 years, rate is 10%. So 2 into 10 over the period of 2 years, the total return earned is 20. First year rate is 8. So how much should be that incremental rate for 1 year? That has to be 12. So 12 divided by 1, that is 12. In this case, there are two options which are close to 12, and therefore maybe the approximation method is not going to work for us. How do we deal with this using the logic method now? So it works like this. Build a simple timeline. So this is time 0, this is time 2. Let us imagine that you've invested hypothetical 100 rupees here at the rate of 10%, that being the spot rate for 2 years. How much money will you have at the end of second year? So using the Texas Instrument calculator, second clear TVM, 100 present value, 2 is N, 10 IY, compute future value. The amount that we will have at the end of second year is 121. Now, what if you invest your amount only for 1 year at the rate of 8%? So you invest 100. By the end of the year, you should have 108. 1 year forward rate 1 year from now means, what is that rate at which you invest your 108 for 1 year in such a way that it should become 121 so that both the roots give you the same future value? So again, making use of the Texas Instrument calculator, second clear TVM. In this case, 108 negative present value, 121 future value, 1N compute IY, which gives us 12.04, which is closest to the option A that we have in this case. The third way in which we can solve or approach this question is to use the formula method, which in this case would be 1.1 raised to 2 divided by 1.08 minus 1 into 100. Let's see how much that gives us. So 1.1 x square divided by 1.08 minus 1 into 100, and that gives us again 12.04, and therefore we go with option A.